So, first, we have a round of introductions. My name is Professor Dr. Mahul Brahma, the Dean of School of Media and Communication. And we are basically doing a debate today as a part of our evening engagement sessions. And the debate is on be silly, be slow. Whether it is doable in today's day and age of speed and seriousness or not. Okay. So I'll explain what it is about and then we'll have a quick round of introduction of all the participants to and against. So the idea is that, see, in our lives, typically, যখন দেখি যে এত ইনফরমেশন আমরা যখন ফোন খুলি একটার পর একটা এত গুলো ফিড ইটস ফিল্ড উইথ ফেসবুক ফিডস ফিল্ড উইথ ইনস্টাগ্রাম ফিডস টুইটার ফিডস অ্যান্ড সামহাউ উই ফিল আ কম্পালশন টু কাইন্ড অফ অ্যাট লিস্ট চেক ইচ অ্যান্ড এভরি ওয়ান অফ দেম ইফ নট কমেন্ট অর লাইক অর ডিসলাইক তাতে যেটা হয় দ্যাট উই এন্ড আপ বিইং আ পার্ট অফ দিস ফাস্ট পেসড world which is doled out at us. Now imagine if you are spending say half a second with somebody's post, the engagement is of half a second and then you move to the second post, third post, or somebody's opinion and second and third opinion. What is going on in your mind? Are you able to generate an original thinking process out of it? So if you like some place, Do you pause? Do you check out the photograph? Do you Google that, okay, this is a nice destination, let's see what are the other destinations around this place? Or somebody is talking about a movie, do you kind of stop there, stop surfing, and then open another thing and check out the movie, check out the ratings and all that? We may do it later, but when we are surfing, we are so engrossed in that overdose of information that we kind of stop thinking, you know, it's like a haze. And that is where being fast is important, because otherwise you will not be able to come on the ground. Taratari na dikhle, you will not be able to come on the ground. Seriousness is about that, it's even in class, or outside your parents, they always tell you, you should grow up, you should be serious about your career, you should be serious about. It's a very common thing. We also ask as teachers that, you know, be serious about studies. Now, I remember when I was a child, my mother has told me this, that I'm pretty fond of toy guns. And we had gone to a certain fest or something like that, and I had asked for a toy gun, and my father refused to buy it. So I kind of, you know, laid down on the ground and cried and this and that. Really didn't see, and finally my father was able to buy it and so that pacified. Now it's silly. But it's acceptable because I was 4 years old. Now imagine me doing it today for something else. Maybe not for a toy gun, but maybe for something else. You know, that silliness is not acceptable. Because I am of a certain age. And therefore, it's not acceptable. But when I become, say, overtly ambitious to acquire a company, and I am not sleeping, I'm not eating, I'm not drinking, I just want it, just like a toy gun. But I'm looking at an acquisition. Suppose I'm Adani, I'm looking at NDT. I just want it. You know, I don't want to sleep, I don't want to eat till the time I get it. It's a very similar sentiment of what I had when I wanted that company. So I was desperate, I just needed and I would not, you know, take no for an answer. So there is this twist wherein silliness, yes, is acceptable, but the ecosystem allows certain silliness and does not allow certain others. You know? But seriousness is acceptable everywhere and it is needed. I'm not asking you not to be serious, but all I'm saying is, typically, you guys had a phase of this classroom from home. from whom you had to attend classes and all. Anybody? Have? So, you behave in a certain way, completely comfortable, shopping, music, right? But what happens when that screen is on? You guys never switched on your screens, by the way. But had you done it, ideal situation, do you think it was possible for you to behave in that? You had to be serious in front of the screen because you are basically replicating the image of the classroom at home. Yes or no? Right? So, therefore, you are bringing, importing that seriousness that is supposed to be in the classroom to home, where you are supposed to be silly as well. You know, your mother has, you know, accepted the fact that you do crazy things, and so has your father. But now you're not doing it. So maybe at one point of time, the ecosystem enables us to transform ourselves. And at the end, what we do is that we stop. If you guys remember, there was an incident where this British minister was having a phone call with, I think, the Prime Minister and three, four other people, very important people. And then the child, you know, rushed into the room and you know, created a noise and all that, and he was very embarrassed. He got up, and so the Prime Minister or somebody else said that, no, why don't you bring him to camera and all that. So that is the reality. We are our home space where I can allow my child to be crazy and cry and be on my lap or do whatever he or she wants. I am invading that space with the seriousness of the office. So at one point of time, when you think about it, there is a blur that has gone. Second is the lack of original thought process. See, when you are bombarded with so much information and from multiple elements, maybe your phone, maybe your laptop, it can be your podcast, it can be your in shorts, the news that comes in shorts, or in social media, Facebook people share news. That is most read, more widely read than from newspapers. You know, in many cases, those news are manipulated. You know, the headline is created, tweaked to fit an agenda. But we are so busy browsing that we don't read beyond the headline. You're getting my point? And if you don't read beyond the headline, you don't know the agenda that is being pushed, and you forwarding it, becoming a part of that agenda, unwittingly. So this is where we need to slow down. Because see, from one activity to another, it takes 15 minutes for your brain to shift. From here, if I do something else, pick up a book and read, my brain will take 15 minutes because this is a space which is quite mentally engaging, and then I have to go there. Right? So that transition takes 15 minutes. Now imagine the number of transitions we end up doing in a single day. So therefore, no transition is complete, no activity is complete. So anyway, so that's the premise of my new book, which is mostly missing, be silly, be slow. So I thought, why don't we have a quick debate session wherein be silly, be slow is what we are looking at. So one team will be for it, the other team will be against it. And whether you want to argue or not, I mean, we can kind of be a little flexible in terms of our, this thing, it can be an anecdote. I mean, you can just share an anecdote where you think you were really silly, or where you think that you need to be serious, I think, but you were silly, or, a point where you, an incident where you thought that you reacted too quickly. It may be an anecdote as well. So I'm not calling it a debate per se, but it is just a discussion. From your own story or story, from and later, the audience can also participate. So just introduce yourself from Mara, and then we'll...
Good evening, everyone.
I am Mira
Sabha from MBA Communication Management Department of School of Business. Panda from BSc Media Technology, Semester 4, SOMC. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Shachita Ghosh, currently in Semester 5, B Media Communication.
Good evening, this is Arun Dutta, BSc Media Technology, 5th Sem.
So we'll start with you. Any story, any anecdote that you want to share? It's not having a debate, we can do a discussion. कोई प्रॉब्लम
सर ये 20 से 20 लोग के अगेंस्ट तो मैं नहीं जा सकती क्योंकि सच में अभी जिस हिसाब से हम लोग चल रहे हैं स्टडी या मैं खुद को अभी देख रही हूँ जिस टाइम से मैं गुजर रही हूँ तो हम लोग पहले का जो टाइम था हम लोग किसी चीज़ पे फोकस करते थे टाइम देते थे किसी चीज़ को बट अभी इतना ज़्यादा इंगेजमेंट हो गया है इतना ज़्यादा प्रेशर हो गया है या आप देख लो कॉम्पिटिशन इतना ज़्यादा हो गया था हम एक साथ कई चीज़ों को सोचते हैं कई चीज़ों पर काम करते हैं तो वो क्या होता है कि सच में एक चीज़ें पूरी नहीं हो पाती मतलब एक चीज़ को हम छोड़ करके दूसरी चीज़ पर शिफ्ट होते हैं तो वो चीज़ टाइम नहीं मिल पाता निकलने का और फोकस किसी पर नहीं हो पाता कंप्लीट कुछ भी नहीं कर पाता है तो वो एक चीज़ हो जा रहा है और जैसे आपने इंस्टाग्राम या किसी भी सोशल साइट का एग्जाम्पल दिया सच में हम क्या करते हैं कि बैठते हैं थोड़ी देर के लिए स्क्रोल कर रहे हैं कई तरह के पोस्ट देखने को मिलते हैं क्या होता है कि हम जज करने लगते हैं हेडलाइन देखा बी सी डी बी स्क्रोल मतलब क्या अगर कोई हेडलाइन वो मिसिंग वाला नहीं पड़े बीस की बीस लोग पड़ेगा तो सच में उसको नहीं लगेगा कि क्या मतलब इस चीज़ का बीस उसको आदमी अभी बैठ कर के अगर स्लो और स्लो हो जाए तो फिर इम्प्रूवमेंट कैसे देखेगा जब वो उसको पूरा बैठ करके पढ़ेंगे तब उसका डीप समझ में आएगा तब इंसान सच में अभी क्या कर रहा है अगर फास्ट होने के चक्कर में किन चीज़ों को मिस कर रहा है उस चीज़ों को समझ पाएगा तो ये बहुत इम्पॉर्टेंट है हमारे लिए और एडवांटेज ये है सबसे बड़ा कि आप हमारे डी नॉक्सेस को देख रहे हो तो वो है कि हम लोग को डायरेक्ट आपके थ्रू मिलेगा उसका कि क्या क्या किस चीज़ को सोच करके आपने उस चीज़ पर लिखा है और सिर्फ पढ़ने के अलावा हो सकता है बहुत सारी चीज़ें हमें समझ ना आए तो वो आप थैंक यू सो मच
थैंक यू
सर आप সারা দিনের মধ্যে আমরা সকাল থেকে উঠছি মেশিনের মতো কাজ করে যাচ্ছি মানে উঠে ব্রাশ করছি দৌড়চ্ছি কলেজ চলে আসছি এর মধ্যে কলেজ আসার মধ্যে অনেক কিছু ঘটে যাচ্ছে আমি যখন রাস্তা দিয়ে আসছি তখন দেখতে দেখতে আসছি সম্পূর্ণ সিনারিটা সেই সিনারিতে ছোটোবেলার ওই সিনারি নেই বড় মেলা অনেক কিছু আছে কিন্তু সেটা যদি আমরা ধরুন স্লো না যাই স্লো বলতে এখানে আমরা তো এখন নিজেকে সময় দিতে ভুলে গেছি নিজেকে সময় আমরা দিচ্ছি না নিজেকে আমরা সময় দিচ্ছি না আমরা পুরো সময়টাই অন্যদের ডেডিকেট করে দিচ্ছি বা আরও মোস্ট প্রিসাইসলি বলতে গেলে আমরা বিক্রি করে দিচ্ছি সময়টা কারণ না কারোর কাছে কখনো না কখনো সেটা ইন্টার্নশিপ হোক বা যাই হোক এনিথিং আমি আমার এজ গ্রুপ দিয়ে বলছি সেটা ভ্যারি করবে আমরা সময় বিক্রি করছি আমাদের নিজেদের জন্য কোনো আমাদের কাছে সময় নেই আমরা যে আমাদের নিয়ে ভাববো আমরা সকালবেলা উঠে ছোটোবেলায় কী হতো ছোটোবেলায় উঠে মায়ের সাথে ছাদে গেলাম খানিকক্ষণ পাখিটাকে দেখলাম গাছে জল দিলাম এই যে ব্যাপারগুলো হচ্ছে এই ব্যাপারগুলো এখন হচ্ছে না গাছে কটা ফুল ফুটছে বাড়িতে কী ফুল ফুটছে শিউলি ফুটেছে না কী ফুটেছে আমি জানি না আমি মানে এই খবরগুলো জানি না আমাদের কাজের মাসে কোন মাসে ছেড়ে দিচ্ছে কোন মাসে নতুন কাজের মাসে আসছে এগুলো জানি না কিন্তু এটা আমি একটা সময় জানতাম যে সময় ফেসবুক হোয়াটসঅ্যাপ ছিল না আমাকে ফেসবুকে দেখতে হতো না পাশের বাড়িতে কী হচ্ছে এখন পাশের বাড়ির খবরটাও আমরা জানি পাশের বাড়ির খবরটা ইনস্টাগ্রাম স্কোর করে করে দেখতে হচ্ছে তো এই সময় দাঁড়িয়ে এটা আমার মনে হয় সত্যি জরুরি আমি সেদিনকেও যে এখানে যে আর্টিকেলটা পড়লাম আমার সেখানে আমি বলছি যে আমাদের বারবারই আমি চাইছি যে আমরা পেছনে ফিরি যেখানে সারগুলো আছে যেখানে নিজেদের জন্য সময় আছে নিজেদের ওপর কনসেন্ট্রেশন করার মতন সময় আছে সব সময় আমি কি করছি অন্যের জন্য কি করছি মানে পুরো সময়টাকেই আমি ডিভিশন করে রাখছি চার পাঁচটা মানুষের মধ্যে সেখানে আমি নেই আমি ছাড়া সবাই আছে এই ঘটনাটা করলে হবে তো আমি চাইছি আমরা আবার সেই ইনোসেন্সটা বা আপনি যেটা বারবার বলছেন যে বিস হিলি বিস লো আমি এটা সম্পূর্ণভাবে এগ্রি করছি
আমরা যখন আমি আগে বাড়িতে যখন থাকতাম
বোঝা করবে জন্য বিকজ নাও এই আইডিয়াসগুলো মাইন্ডে আসে। যেমনি এক্সাম্পল কালকে বিকেলে যখন কলেজ কালকে আসলো শরীরটা খারাপ ছিল, তো কালকে জাস্ট নর্মালি এমনি বই পড়ছিলাম আমরা, বই পড়তে 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 জাস্ট নর্মাল কফি খেতে খেতে বলতে জাস্ট এমনি ভাবছিলাম, পেন নিয়ে লেখা ফেঁকা এই ওই কিছু করছিলাম সেরকম কিছু, বাট স্ক্রিপ্টিং করতে 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 আই জাস্ট মেড আ আউট অফ ইট। সো সামটাইমস ইউ নিড টু জাস্ট লেট ইট গো, লেট ইট ফ্লো ইয়োর সেলফ, লেট লেট ইয়োর থটস ফ্লো সো দ্যাট ইউ ক্যান কাম সামথিং উইথ সামথিং নিউ আউট অফ দ্য বক্স।
আমি একটা অ্যানেকডোট শেয়ার করতে চাই। আমাদের এই যে ফ্যাশন জিনিসটা না, এটা খুবই সবার থাকে কি থাকে না এটা ইজ রিলেটেবল কোয়েশ্চেন, হয়তো খুব অ্যাভারেন্ট ইট নিডস টু বি নারিশড, ইট নিডস টু বি নার্চার্ড অ্যান্ড ইটস দ্য রিজন। এই জিনিসটা একবার যখন হারিয়ে যায় তখন এটাকে ফিরিয়ে আনা খুব ডিফিকাল্ট, এবং এবং এই এই এত ব্যস্ততার মাঝখানে এত কিছু কাজের মাঝখানে দিস প্যাশন ইজ হোল্ডিং অন টু দিস প্যাশন ইজ ইজ কনসিডার্ড অ্যাজ সিরিয়াস অ্যাজ ইউ লাইক টু পয়েন্ট আউট টু লাইক আর্ট রাইট নাও দ্য পয়েন্ট ইজ I just an anecdote which I have shared in the book as well is that you guys are aware perhaps that I was in this movie Oparajita. So Oparajita Balmata would say Shrijit Raya's Pathet Panchali making time. So the making of Pathet Panchali. The film is about the making of the film. So even in real life, Shubhut Vip, Jini Unar Simbara Prakash, Pathet Panchali. Shubhutur Mitra was a still photographer. Okay. Now imagine Shubhutra making his first film and he takes a still photographer as a cinematographer in the first film. You know, because the existing cinematographers, they refused to primarily to shoot outdoor because they want to shoot in controlled environment. Studio mote ki hoy light ta control thake by day hota shoot holo gelo bishti porlo gelo, people were not comfortable, the existing established cinematographers were not comfortable with so many variables, thik ache, but Shubhutur Mitra had the passion ebong shei bhabe kintu oi bounce light er je concept ta seta Shubhutur Mitra first use kore ebong innovate kore. This is how history happens when you do something crazy, and ei jaygay onar conviction chilo shudhi jay o tin koreche ebong Pathet Panchali je cinematography is one of the perhaps something we it's kind of a legendary movie, every work every bit of it art design theke shuru kore shomosto kichu, so ei jinish ta mathay rakhte hobe je if we are serious about something, you have to really, really listen. So that is something that I think anybody who's doing anything creative, so you know what a person is, person. So basically it's a long pipe, okay? And sometimes person runs for even 9 meter, 9 feet person. And there's this wind issue. So it had to appear and then it played. Now imagine who in the right mind, when you're in college or late school and all that, would pick up bassoon as a musical instrument of their choice and not a guitar. You're getting my point. You really have to be silly to make that conscious choice. Guitar is smart. You know, it's like, okay, why did everybody get a guitar? So it's smart, it's catchy, it's not a, but imagine somebody who's walking in with a, you know, 7-8 feet long box and then opening it, you know, needs help in putting it up in one place. It's not even challenge, everybody knows now. It's a bassoon. Now, if somebody loves to play the bassoon, he really has to think against all these odds. That should I do it or should I not? Then you watch it. This is very, very important. Finally, he said, okay, well, suppose I'm earning, say, one now, and then I'll be earning 10 times, or maybe 100 times, you know, given the scale that there'll be 1,000 people working for you across different continents and all that, you'll be exporting all over the world. What will happen? So I said, then you will be able to, so many people working for you. You don't have to work. I said, then what? You can enjoy your mind. I said, what do you think I'm doing now? Okay. It's a catch-22 situation. You know, it's like the more you make money, the more you're rich, the more you become rich.
Losing that 100 million.
And then every time you walk into a room, you will not trust anybody because you know everybody will come to you for your money. That is an added stress. Yeah? Way that if you know your word is like there are 1,000 people who have got a certain outcome, so I can ensure the certain outcome for my work. But if my what does this, I don't have a data set of, you know, to what extent there is a high success rate in this area or not. Okay. So to protect, you know, I push my what here. I'm not saying it happens across everybody, but in majority of the cases it happens because it's a game of probability and there's a higher chance of success given the data set. It's a higher data set. Now, the thing is, I remember when I wanted to make a film and all that. So the first question that I was encountered is, "Can you show me how?" Now, it's a very rude thing to say because I'm just starting. So it's like, it's very intimidating also. I mean, you know, unwittingly, you suddenly think of somebody, you know, like a Mount Everest, and you are not even, you know, you are at sea level. So you are basically matching the 8,000 feet up somewhere. So, I mean, so it's very unfair, and that kind of that's not an inspiration, that's an intimidation. You know, that stops you short. Sure, what will I produce? I don't think it's good. I'm not sure. You know, I will never be able to reach that level. Okay. But if you take, you know, you are aware of this Annapurna Base Camp. So Annapurna Base Camp is the Mount Everest Base Camp. Now imagine you are at Annapurna Base Camp and not at sea level. You are getting my point. So you have already, you know, come a lot of way, and then what you have is just a hill because you are already here in the base camp. You've covered this distance, then it's inspiring. You're getting my point. Then you will think, oh my God, I need to make something like that. My first feature.
But
then,
Mr. Mandrija, from the base camp to the highest hill, that time we should be very silly and slow, just to complete ourselves that peak.
Absolutely. But because you've covered this distance, that same statement, which was an intimidation maybe 5 years back, when you thought of making your first film, is now an inspiration. So once you reach there, the base camp, and people can see that there is some success in terms of the response of the film, then the second question will come, Kanijam, the Cannes Film Festival. So such things keep coming. That's an integral part of life. And I remember when I actually got a call from Cannes Film Festival, there was nothing further to add. So at one point of time, if you start taking these statements very seriously, the burden that accumulates will not let you pursue anything that you have. Only things are, so I remember Osho used to say that to people only death is acceptable, not theirs, somebody else's. So if you remember the story of the donkey and this guy on a donkey, and then somebody says that, look at this fool, how he's giving pain to the donkey, and then he gets down, and then the donkey, and somebody else says that, you know, there's a donkey and he's walking. What a fool he is. So all these things happen. Whatever you do, there will be some people who will call it stupid, call you fool, call you silly, anything. But at the end, remember that there is a commitment that you have towards yourself, about your life. And for that commitment, there is a need to take it slow, because you don't want to be a part of the crowd. You don't want to be a part of the crowd that is throwing, you know, that huge amount of information per second to you, so that you don't think, you just act, you react rather. Okay, that is a point wherein you need to take it slow, and then think, start thinking that why was this written? So if you remember in the people who attended my class, I always say that consume every content, whether it's ad or a film or the news or whatever, critically. Know that what can be an agenda? Is it biased? Is it unbiased? Is it the best way to present this news? What is the news that is wants to present? Is it aligned? Is the headline aligned? If the headline is not aligned, why is it not aligned? Is there an agenda behind it? See, a Supreme Court decree, you can't change the content. But imagine the play of words that the headline does to you, presenting the same decree in various other forms, the same judgment in various other forms. If you study news, you know. So that is the manipulation that can only happen when you don't consume it critically. To critically consume it, you have to take it. So anyway, I just want to thank all of you. And I'm so glad that the three schools have participated in that, in our discussion. And thanks to my colleagues for organizing it. Thanks to the students who are working behind the camera. Good work. And thanks so much. We call it a close today.
Thank you.
Be silly, be slow.
Thank you.